Hi, you're on Rescue TV with an incredibly special guest, Miss Celine Cousteau. Welcome to Rescue.
Thank
you. And welcome to Sydney.
I know. It's a beautiful city. Today it's a little bit grey. But
it's okay. The sun always shines in Sydney. It'll always come out.
That's true. Well, I'm here for 7 weeks, so I have time.
So let's first of all get some perspective as to why you are here in Sydney, because you do have a connection to Australia that's a lot of people don't know about.
Well, my partner was raised in Australia, actually just inland from Noosa. And so we're up there for a bit of time, and then he spent quite a few years in Manly. So we're going to come down here for the holidays.
Well, you are really seeing the highlights of Australia. We won't feel sorry for you. One of the reasons that we're so excited to have you is, of course, you are Jacques Cousteau's granddaughter, and you're an ambassador for a very special brand to the Rescue Readers, La Prairie, for the Advanced Marine Biology line. Tell us a little bit about the work that you're doing around the world.
Wow. I mostly work on documentaries, either as a host or as a producer and director. Right now I have launched and launching the website for a nonprofit organization called Cause Centric Productions, and that's creating short documentaries about the work of grassroots organizations and individuals who are looking at implementing solutions to sociocultural and environmental issues.
So the apple didn't fall far from the tree.
The apple didn't fall far from the tree, although the apple went for a tour around the world before it came back. I studied psychology, so my interest really is looking at human behavior and now applying that to the environment, our human relationship to our natural world. So most of the year you can find me out on expedition or sitting at my desk behind my computer getting ready. I have a 10-and-a-half-month-old son, so the past year has been really about taking care of him and getting ready for next year's expeditions. But I'm also working as the ambassador to La Prairie's Advanced Marine Biology Collection.
Which is a really wonderful and symbiotic relationship, because I'm sure that it would be very difficult for you to make a decision as to what to lend your name and your expertise to. So tell us about the partnership and how it came about.
The partnership came about in a very personal way. It wasn't necessarily a business transaction. Lynn Florio, the president of La Prairie, and I met, and we just talked about the idea of what we could create together. The reason that we met is that Advanced Marine Biology uses a lot of marine ingredients, and what I had learned is that they use them by growing them in laboratories through aquaculture as opposed to taking them from the ocean.
Which and kind of feeds into your own belief of preserving the natural ecosystems.
Yeah, and I really, you look at the cosmetic industry or any other industry, how can we use our natural resources in sustainable ways? So Lynn and I sat down, we had a personal conversation about our visions in life, and we decided that we could work together and that we would create this vision together and see where it took us. And 5 years later, we're still together.
So you really came from it without knowing too much about the beauty industry.
Yes, and it was actually a co-learning process in a sense of me asking, why is it that we can't have a 3-in-1 product? Why can't I just use one thing every day? And also just learning really what cosmetics was all about, the fact that a lot of cosmetics use marine ingredients, and that this is a great example of doing that in a sustainable way.
So sustainability is obviously a core part of what you take around the world, and it's the heritage that you bring to so many projects. Tell us a little bit about some of the areas in the world that you're particularly passionate about, that you think that our readers need to know about in terms of marine conservation.
Well, it's interesting. With the last name I have, obviously, a lot of people want to throw me in the ocean all the time, which is just fine by me. I end up in the Amazon quite a bit, though, out of my own volition. I was there when I was 9 years old with my grandfather on Calypso for a couple of weeks.
Wow.
My grandmother was on the boat. My mom was off somewhere, inland. And I think that really stayed with me, because as an adult, I keep going back. And the life of indigenous people, their relationship with the environment, is something that really resonates with me. So I end up going back to the Amazon quite a bit.
Now, I want, of course, the most natural question to ask, because you have the connection to Australia, is when are you going to help the Great Barrier Reef?
Well, actually, the time that I'm spending here is actually really good. I'm meeting a lot of people who are giving me ideas and connections. I would love to do just a series of short interviews with people I meet along the way in a very informal way. I did a project in Australia many years ago called Mysteries of the Shark Coast.
Wow.
We were filming different shark species with scientists who were doing research. So there will be a time when I will come back to Australia and do a project, I'm sure.
Now, for somebody who's so immersed in nature and has such a affinity with marine life, do you feel that in all of the studies that you've done, that there really is a great connection between marine extracts and marine ecology, and how to, you know, improve our health and beauty and skin conditions? Have you seen that in a non-cosmetic way before in the work that you've done?
Well, I think you see that in so many ways. Our connections to the oceans are vast. We use different marine ingredients, as we said, in our cosmetics. We eat a lot of marine ingredients, so let's face it, we're definitely connected to our oceans that way. Mm. We also use a lot of marine ingredients in our pharmaceutical industry.
Sure.
A lot of cures are being found in our reef systems. So when we think about ecology, when we think about the environment, it really is about our own human well-being as well. We have a healthy environment, we have healthy humans. So those two things absolutely need to come together as one, and on so many different levels. You don't have to be an environmentalist to be environmentally minded.
So it's a really big step for a cosmetic company such as La Prairie to partner with you to make sure that what they're doing is really responsible for, you know, many decades to come.
It's also about sharing a message, because this relationship isn't just about me talking about the product. La Prairie gives me a platform to talk about the work that I do in relation to my association with them, but also independently of that. And that's also the respectful side of the relationship, to say, let's see where our story is and where it's comfortable and let it happen naturally.
Now, one of the things that we're going to be really treated to today as part of your visit is the opportunity to see some of the photography that you get to do in your travels. So I'm going to actually get you to take us on a little mini tour of some of the beautiful images that you've brought. But thank you so much for joining us.
It's been
a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
And we love the products. Our readers definitely love the products. And I can't wait for the all-in-one. As a working mum, I can tell you that any steps you can reduce is a welcome
addition. Very helpful.
Yeah, very helpful.
Well, and also you should get to the spa at the Darling. They're launching the Advanced Marine Biology
facial. I've been told.
2013, you should go for it.
Here it comes. So we're a million miles away from some of the exotic locales that you visit. But I would love you to take us through some of the incredible portraits that you've done.
Let's not forget, to a lot of people, Australia is exotic.
Okay, yes, we live here. So here we are. Where was this taken?
This photograph was taken in the Brazilian Amazon, actually. Small village that we were filming in, and we were actually working with a local population to help us find all the different animals. What it represents for me is the idea that family really takes care of little ones. Even our little ones take care of each other. So I'm 1 month old being taken care of by a 5 year old. This is a very different place, Papua New Guinea. I was there filming a nonprofit organization, and in this one village, all of the children of the village came together.
You often see that in television, actually, that when you have a film crew or a visitor to a village, that the kids, and they always seem to be of the same age, all come out at once.
They do. It's just a natural curiosity. They just want to see what's going on. It's such an innocence, too, to stare. So it's great.
And it's happy.
Great subjects. Yeah, it's happy.
It's very happy. Yeah. And where are we here? This is a great shot. So
evocative. Thank you.
Like, that's amazing. You have a whole life story in his wrinkles.
Yeah. I think also when people look right into the camera with absolutely no hesitation, you get something very real. Mm-hmm. This is a fisherman off the coast of Chile, Juan Fernandez Archipelago. We were actually quite far out. And we were doing a story on sustainable catch. This picture is also in the Amazon.
Oh, they're playing jump.
Isn't that fun? I mean, you know, you realize nowadays, like, kids need all this technology to have fun, and this is such a simple game, playing jump rope. And this little girl wasn't allowed to jump the rope.
With the boys?
With the boys and the older kids until just when I was taking
these
shots.
And look at her, she's so defiant.
She's just so happy. She's jumping higher than anybody else. I love that look on her face.
It's gorgeous.
So real.
And you know what? You're right, because, you know, this is all happening. They're so intense, but she's getting the thrill.
She's on the top of the world.
I love it. And where are we here? She's beautiful.
We are in Uganda.
I was
filming another nonprofit organization doing some work with an agricultural community, and I was just visiting with some of the farmers there.
So you're really working not just in marine ecosystems and sustainability. It's global on all levels.
Yeah. I have a real interest really in the human connection with our natural world and the things that we can learn from people who are very much still working at the ground level.
Yes.
And highlighting the work of nonprofit organizations that are doing something positive to mitigate negative impact. There's a lot of heroes out there. They need to be heard.
And this little boy, where is he?
This is American Samoa. We were filming the marine protected areas of North America, and he was just gave me about two frames before he turned around and got grumpy.
As they do.
As they do sometimes.
And this is gorgeous.
Little boy. Little boy gorgeous. In the Brazilian Amazon. Just another just really sweet shot. I love taking portraits of people, and he was just in his own little world in that moment.
And they are, this is really, how old is he, about two?
Oh, I'm going to guess about two.
Yeah. It's a great shot.
Little cutie.
And look, we've got indigenous.
Yeah, these
Where
two.
Where is this? Is this for real? I mean,
this is
amazing.
For real. This is for real. We don't stage. I don't ask people to do anything that's out of their own comfort realm. Both of these photographs were taken in Papua New Guinea, doing a story on a nonprofit organization doing research on the use of medicinal plants in traditional culture.
And is he a medicine elder?
He's an elder of the village. She was actually a healer.
Right.
Yeah, so just had an opportunity. And I love photographing older people with just life all over their face.
She actually has remarkably good skin.
She does. Maybe she's a Lucaria.
Maybe. I love it. Yeah. I think what's really beautiful is that you've captured so many different cultures and beauty in lots of different ways. And I think portraiture is always really so evocative. Yeah. And it makes you think that, in Western society, we always classify beauty and we tend to want sameness. Mm-hmm. And there's a homogeneity to what we think is beautiful. Yeah. And yet you look at all the different cultures and you really see beauty. I mean,
definition of beauty is very different in different cultures. In some cultures, women who are voluptuous is beautiful. In other cultures, we want them this skinny. It's the same thing with facial features.
And, wrinkles are gorgeous. I mean, we've seen a couple of photos here where, life etched on your face is really beautiful.
It's a whole life pattern.
Absolutely. Do you exhibit?
I don't, actually. I use my photographs as part of my talks. I do public speaking a lot.
La Prairie has an exhibition.
Someday. Maybe in Australia.
Maybe in Australia. We'll see you again soon.
Oh, I'm sure.
I look forward
Thank
to
you.
It. Pleasure to meet you.
You too.